Welcome. You're logged on to IndianTimesDelhi.com, the only portal for news from India, America, Canada, Punjab and Gujarat. In English, Punjabi and Gujarati with a list of well-established businesses and resources that you may need. I'm Annie Sheikh and today's headlines are... In India, the BJP has demanded an apology from the Congress over MP Shashi Tharoor's cop and jibe at PM Modi and four highly trained snipers are active in Kashmir. In America, President Donald Trump has called the synagogue attack evil and the WTO has set up a dispute panel on the India-US case. In Punjab, commission agents have been warned against delayed payments to the farmers and the SED has alleged that the Congress is harassing SE students. Stay tuned to IndianTimesDelhi.com and I'll be back with the news that's important for you from India, America and Punjab. For detailed news and businesses updates of the Indo-American community, download the Indian Times Daily app. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from India are... Congress MP Shashi Tharoor has quoted an unnamed RSS source and launched a sharp attack on PM Narendra Modi while likening him with a scorpion sitting on a shivling. The BJP reacted strongly to the statement and called for an apology from Congress President Rahul Gandhi. Snapper attack by Jaish-e-Mohammed terrorist has emerged as a new source of worry for security agencies in Kashmir Valley, with three personnel having been killed since mid-September. This has prompted the law enforcement agencies to recalibrate their strategy to thwart such strikes by the Pakistan-based group. Japanese Premier Shinzo Abe has said that PM Narendra Modi was one of his most dependable friends. He stated also that he would like to strengthen bilateral cooperation to realize a free and open Indo-Pacific. PM Narendra Modi has said that only refraining from war cannot ensure peace. Instead, there is a need for united universal cooperation to combat terrorism, climate change and for economic development and social justice. Over 3,300 protesters who prevented women from entering the Sabarimala temple have been arrested since October 26, while 517 cases have been registered at various police stations across Kerala. The latest arrest was that of Sabarimala Tantri family member and activist Rahul Eshwar. Former Chhattisgarh CM Ajit Jogi has said that though he will fight the Congress tooth and nail the upcoming state assembly polls, he will not speak against the Gandhi family. He stated that he shared a warm relationship with them during his long tenure in the Grand Old Party. Former Indian Space Research Organization Chairman G. Madhavan Nair has joined the BJP. Nair was amongst the five prominent people inducted into the party's Kerala unit. India's Zika outbreak is spreading, with officials having said that the mosquito-borne virus has been detected in Gujarat after nearly 150 cases were reported this year in neighbouring Rajasthan. A woman tested positive for Zika and was treated at a hospital in Ahmedabad. The railways plan to use aircraft like pressurised coaches in its trains for the Bilaspur-Manali-Leh line along the India-China border. This will be the world's highest rail track so that passengers do not have breathing difficulties on board. Veteran actor Sanjay Khan says that he has enjoyed several long-lasting friendships in Bollywood but believes that the equation amongst the current crop of actors is so superficial that they are ready to backbite any time. Khan says that these things existed in the industry in his heydays, but there was elegance and class. Stay tuned to Indian Times Daily as the news from America and Punjab follows. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from America are... President Donald Trump mourned the death and forcefully condemned anti-Semitism after a mass shooting at a Pittsburgh synagogue that left 11 dead. The assailant, identified by the law enforcement officials as Robert D. Bowers, has been charged with 29 criminal counts. The WTO's dispute settlement body has set up a panel to examine the US complaint against certain export subsidy measures by India. The US dragged India to the dispute settlement mechanism in March, saying that the incentives were harming the US companies. Defense Secretary James Mattis has said that the US was committed to holding accountable those responsible for killing journalist Jamal Khashoggi. Mattis, speaking to an international security conference, never mentioned Saudi Arabia directly in the connection with the murder. The federal government has sent supplies to a US territory in the Pacific that was ravaged by a super typhoon as residents of the Northern Mariana Islands struggled 2 days after the deadly storm. Super Typhoon Yutu is the strongest storm to hit any part of the US this year. The US military successfully shot down a medium-range ballistic missile in a test of a new interceptor system, which is being co-developed with Japan. The successful operation comes after two failed intercept tests in June 2017 and January 2018. President Donald Trump, who said that he knows the pipe bomb suspect was one of his supporters, but said that he bears no blame for the suspect's actions. Trump pledged to prosecute those responsible for the pipe bomb scare to the fullest extent of the law. A couple from the Indian state of Kerala have plunged to their death while trying to click a selfie during a trek in California. The American consulate reported that the couple slipped and fell off a high point while trying to click a selfie. The bodies were later identified by the police. President Donald Trump accused Twitter of delisting his followers and making it tougher for new people to join as he criticized the microblogging site's efforts to remove fake accounts. Trump, who has 55.3 million followers, accused Twitter of being biased towards him. Simone Biles overcame kidney stone pain to help the USA woman all but guarantee a team final place at the Gymnastics World Championships in Doha. The 10-time world champion scored 60.965 over the four apparatus less than 24 hours after having hospital treatment. Singer Michael Bublé has said that his son Noah is a superhero after beating cancer he was diagnosed with in 2016 at the age of 3. The Grammy Award winner said that his whole life ended when his son was diagnosed and found it too hard to talk about it at first. I'll be back. Stay locked on to IndianTimesDaily.com as the news from Punjab follows. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from Punjab are: Food and Civil Supplies Minister Bharat Bhushan Ashu has warned commission agents of strict action if farmers are paid less during paddy procurement. Ashu claimed that it is duty of the state to make payments to farmers within 48 hours. The SED has alleged that the Congress government was harassing SC students after failing to release Rs 442 crore central grant for post-matric scholarship. The SED said that this was the reason that the government was demanding income certificates from new applicants to derail the entire scheme. Hundreds of women contractual teachers observed a 24-hour fast for regularization of their services on Karwa Chauth. Protesters also applied henna on their hands and raised slogans against state government. Leaders of SED and BJP took part in a bhog ceremony of Akhand Path organized in memory of victims of the Amritsar train tragedy. The SED and the BJP took a jibe at CM Amrinder Singh and demanded a compensation of Rs 1 crore to each family. The BSP has initiated a move to bring Dalits under the party's banner to strengthen the Dalit base in the state in view of the upcoming Lok Sabha elections. Retired IAS officer and founder president of the state Bahujan Mukti Party Khushi Ram has joined the BSP. SED President Sukhbir Badal has held a meeting with SGPC members and SED MLAs, but disgruntled party leaders chose to stay away. While speaking to the media, Sukhbir ducked repeated queries over the absence and resignations of the disgruntled party leaders. The state is set to merge 20 district central cooperative banks with the Punjab State Cooperative Bank to enhance business. The decision has been taken by the State Cooperation Minister Sukhjinder Singh Randhawa. SED Vice President of Malwa Zone Dalip Kumar Bola has been booked on charges of rape. A 37-year-old Dalit woman had alleged that Bola exploited her at gunpoint after kidnapping her a year ago. Bola has denied this accusation. The state will earmark 100 acres of land in the upcoming high-tech cycle valley in Ludhiana. This is for the development of a state-of-the-art industrial park and to boost the cycle and light engineering industry. Jaipur Pink Panthers will shift their home leg of Pro Kabaddi League to Tau Devi Lal Indoor Stadium in Panchkula as their home venue is under construction. The home leg for Jaipur Pink Panthers will begin on December 14th and will conclude on December 20th. This is the end of the news bulletin, but stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com as the news from Bollywood is coming up next. And do visit the resources section on this portal to find the best Indo-American businesses and resources from accounting firms to wedding planners in your city. All of us at Indian Times Daily wish that you have a great day.
It's such a delight to see Shah Rukh Khan in a never-seen-before avatar, a dwarf in his upcoming film, Zero. We've already seen the much-awaited teaser of the film. Now, Shah Rukh's character, Bahuwas Singh, makes his grand social media debut with Amitabh Bachchan, Farah Khan and other big celebs following him on Twitter. In his second tweet, Bahuwas Singh mentioned Shah Rukh and asked, "Are bhai Shah Rukh, meri mummy ne aaj aapko bahut bada compliment diya. बोली आप मेरे जैसे दिखते हैं हमने कहा हाँ डिम्पल तो सेम है पर ड्रेसिंग सेंस अपना थोड़ा ठीक करो गुरु ऑन दैट शाहरुख खान रिप्लाइड बाबा सिंह मेरी मम्मी कहती थी आदमी कपड़े बनाता है कपड़े आदमी को नहीं। आपकी डीपी देख के लगता है कि 7 जन्म में भी मेरा ड्रेसिंग सेंस आप सा नहीं हो पाएगा। बाकी डिम्पल्स हैं मेरे आपके जैसे, उसके लिए थैंक्स। तुम बहुत कच्चे इंसान हो, ऊप्स अच्छे इंसान लगते हो। डजंट दैट टिकल योर फनी बोन्स। द मूवी ऑल्सो स्टार्स अनुष्का शर्मा एंड कैटरीना कैफ इन पिविटल रोल्स, डायरेक्टेड बाय आनंद एल रॉय। द टीज़र ऑफ द मूवी केम आउट ऑन ईद दिस ईयर, फीचरिंग सलमान खान एंड शाहरुख खान। The movie is slated for release on December 21st, 2018. As the rise of the Me Too movement in India has opened many dark spaces of Bollywood, actor Saif Ali Khan, whose daughter Sara Ali Khan is gearing up for her Bollywood debut, feels no one has the guts to mess with his family members. It is a very unequal society. I don't think anyone will misbehave with my people. I don't know why I feel like this, but be it my mother or sister or wife, I feel people will not have the guts to do that with them. It might be because they have certain protection around them. So we have to protect the ladies who don't have the protection around them or that aura that protects them. We have to make the place safe for the vulnerable ladies, Saif told IANS. The 48-year-old actor has urged people to respect everyone as he feels there's more to life than getting shit from each other. On the acting front, Saif has been on a roll. After wooing the audience with his role as a police officer in Sacred Games, Saif's latest film, Bazaar, sees him portray a rich Gujarati stock trader. Karwa Chauth is finally here, the day on which all the married women observe a fast for their husband's long life and prosperity. Like others, our Bollywood divas are not far behind in celebrating Karwa Chauth. Known to be a power couple, actor Abhishek Bachchan will not let his wife Aishwarya Rai Bachchan alone. Yes, you heard it right. Abhishek is all set to fast with his lady love all day. The actor asked other husbands to support their wives in keeping the fast by doing it with them. He tweeted, "Karwa Chauth, good luck ladies, and the dutiful husbands who should also be fasting with their wives, I do." Also, actor Ayushman Khurrana has kept a Karwa Chauth fast for his wife Tahira Kashyap, who has been detected with pre-invasive breast cancer. Ayushman on Saturday took to Instagram, where he shared a photograph of his palm on which the letter T, Tahira, in Hindi was written with henna. He captioned it, "She can't fast this time, but I will, for her good health and long life, Karwa Chauth." On September 22nd, Tahira revealed that she has been detected with pre-invasive breast cancer. Bollywood ace director Karan Johar will get candid with Shahid Kapoor and brother Ishan Khattar on his chat show Coffee with Karan. The news is confirmed by Ishan Khattar only. During an event in National Capital, when Ishan was asked about his and brother Shahid's visit at Coffee with Karan, he said,
"We've also been hearing rumors that you'll be appearing on Karan Johar's chat show Coffee with Karan with Shahid Kapoor. Is there any truth to it? Are you excited now?"
That's for them to announce. you know what? Yeah, I am. Yes, I will be on there with my brother.
Okay. Are you excited?
Be fun. No? Yeah, super excited. Come on, have you seen the hamper? I want that. I have my eyes on that.
But do you think that you will be able to compete with Shahid, who's been on the show before?
For that hamper, I will compete with him, yes.
And last question, would we see you dancing with him on the show? Is there
any chance? I mean, don't be surprised if we do. I mean, there's no such plan. It's not devised, but maybe we will.
The show is popular for creating controversies over chats and comments by the B-Town celebs gracing the show. The first episode is already out, starring Deepika Padukone and Alia Bhatt. Karan Johar launched Ishan Khattar and Janhvi Kapoor in Hindi remake of Sai Raat. Well, we just can't wait to watch the brothers in the show. Hearing on two appeals pertaining to two poaching cases against Bollywood actor Salman Khan were deferred to December 18th by a Sessions Court here on Friday due to lack of time. There are two appeals pending in the Sessions Court, one each by the government against acquittal of Khan in the Arms Act case and one by Khan himself challenging the conviction in a poaching case, said Khan's counsel Mahesh Bora. Both were deferred due to unavailability of enough time with the court. Before this, hearing on the two applications moved by prosecution against Khan was also deferred till November 29th. One of these applications was moved by the prosecution, alleging that Khan had misled the court to obtain exemption from appearance in the court on the ground of a physical problem, while the other application had alleged that Khan had given false information about his arms through an affidavit. Khan was sentenced to 5 years by the trial court, convicting him in a case under Wildlife Protection Act for killing two black bucks in Konkani of Jodhpur in 1998.